Hello everyone. Yes, I know. Minecraft. It's been a little while. We are on 1.11. We've been on 1.11 for a while. I have installed a thing with command blocks for 1.11, which is pretty cool. My library apparently self-deployed there. Because we've replaced skeleton horse traps with shulkers. I might have to review that system because shulkers don't despawn at all, ever. So that system may be subject to review, but that's there. We're not on 1.11. Frig. Frig. Get away from the creepers. We're not on 1.11.2 yet because we're waiting for Spigot to update. So there's a couple of things to take care of in preparation for that. One is that everyone's going to want to stock up on bows that have both affinity and mending, because as long as they're made before you update to 1.11.2, you can keep them. So that's that. These things are going to be irrelevant, pretty much. And yeah. Jade left this. Presents from Jade. The Mirror's Edge cookie. That was in response to a comment I made to her during my Mirror's Edge LP that I said something about. Oh, I can't remember what it was. I said something and she interpreted it as a prediction when I was just describing what happened in the video, while after having just finished editing it, or while I was editing it, one or the other. So she gave me a cookie, and I was like, "Okay, it wasn't a prediction, but I'll have a cookie." So that's the overly verbose. The joke here is Totem of Undying will save you if you fall and take too much damage. That being, if you haven't watched my Mirror's Edge series, you should. It was a frustrating game, but I enjoyed it. I'm very glad I played it. So I have a Totem Undying, which is cool. I'm curious. This is a bit cheaty, but I'm curious. There are no shulkers within render distance of me here. That's disappointing. So yeah, shulker boxes are going to be a thing to get into. Anything else happened around here? I don't think so. Oh yeah, there was another thing. Did I have this in the last episode? I can't remember. No, I don't think I did. This was Mojo Beast. Check this out. Stone, 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 torch. Stone, stone, torch. It's hopper dropper in item form. And I could use all that stuff to build it out again like I did on the last world, except I'd need a bit more redstone. So that's that. That was fun when I found that. I still need a replacement horse after the disaster of last episode. So what are my plans for this episode? Well, bits and bobs mostly. I don't know. If this episode goes out on Monday the 26th, as I'm intending, it's going to be a Minecraft double bill because there will be the first episode of the first cross-community games UHC going out at the same time on the same day. This may not go out on the 26th, though. It depends whether I get a full episode. Haven't been to a Woodland Mansion yet. Haven't done anything in 1.11 yet, really. What is with my elytra today? What was I saying? So this video may not go out on the 26th. It depends on whether. Shut up, guests. On whether I get stuff done. So, yeah, the main thing to talk about is the witch farm. We are starting to actually plan stuff for the witch farm. I'll go into my copy of the world and show you kind of my designy plans-ish in a minute, probably. But the witch farm is a project we are probably going to actually get on with soon, and it's about time because we've had this world since 1.9, so it's been, what is that, 9 months? No, I can maths. 7 months ish, something. May, 8 months, something like that. 8 months, I think. And the reason we chose, well, one of the reasons we chose the seed for this world to be what it was, we chose it for the ocean spawn chunks, the blaze spawners, dual blaze spawners, right near in the middle of the world, which I made into the blaze farm, obviously, and the quad witch huts. So obviously we want to actually start making use of that. Let's go and check. I think another person might have signed up, so I think we might just be down to two slots. Let's have a look for the upper caving. I'm really sort of rambling and not keeping a coherent train of thought here, aren't I? A horse. Let's have a look. Nope, still three signing up spaces left. I do like this cave. I'm still pretty pleased with this cave. So yeah, that's obviously not happening particularly soon. But yeah, in relation to the witch farm, obviously that will produce gunpowder, and obviously, come 1.11.2, we're going to want lots of gunpowder because we're going to want lots of fireworks. And I am hoping to be the person who capitalises on that as a business opportunity. Server latency, please. So, why am I coming this way? I want to head over to the shopping district. I mean, I could just go back into the Nether, but that's boring. So, witch huts are over there, shopping district is over here, ish. Right, any sign of anyone building anything vaguely fireworky yet? Totems now in stock, eh? Okay, someone's got a nice chorus flower thing. That's totems, elytra, shulker boxes. 5 diamonds, not bad. 32 diamonds for an elytra. I still want to try and compete with this shop because I've got my bone farm, I've got my slime farm, and the blaze farm. I can totally compete with these guys on that. I wonder if anyone's been in my shop since I last checked. Probably not. Let's stick you in there, you in there, yeah, and I'll just hold on to this because they're not important. So yeah, that's sort of the update on where things stand on the server right at the minute. And I guess it's going to be a case of go and get some wool so I can build a giant firework shop facade thing. I wonder where I'll build it. Probably not too far from my shop. Maybe just like there. Although on top of a hill would probably be cool, because it'll stand out more then. It's got to be somewhere fairly accessible. I'd have to think about that a little bit. But yeah, witch huts. Let's go into my copy of the world where I did some building and stuff. You see, that's just a skeleton horse that's left over from a trap, so that's not replaced by a shulker. The command blocks explicitly look for active traps that are primed but not triggered. So there are still odd skeleton horses here and there, because I didn't want to replace everyone's skeleton horses that they've quote-unquote tamed. Of course, they spawn tamed from a trap, which is why I can't actually distinguish. Oh, there's a shulker. I haven't fought a shulker since I went to get my light. Well, I barely even fought them there. I just sort of avoided them, really. So this should be cool. Just clear the area, make sure it's as safe as possible. This is the first time I've seen a completely natural, you know what I mean. Not one that I spawned in to test the command blocks are working. Essentially is what I mean. It's the first wild shulker in its unnatural habitat. Stop spawning. Oh my god, will you stop spawning? No, you must have already been there. You're too close to me. You couldn't have spawned. Stop. I could just sleep. That'd make things easier. Is there a bed around here? Must be a bed around here, right? Right. Let's go and actually kill this shulker then. Or try to, anyway. That was easy. No shell? No, shells. Excellent. Well, one. That's my first half of a shulker box. Nice. I wonder if there are any more around here. Aren't any particularly good reasons to believe that there would be. But it's worth a look. So here we are in the super, mega, absolutely idealised world where I've filled in all the caves underneath. Literally. I mean, obviously there's lava pockets and stuff, but nothing can spawn there, so that's the point. And the surface is all water, and so on. And this is Sumer's design. We could do the awesome slime block pusher one, but I'm worried about how much lag the pistons, or that many pistons firing on a regular basis would cause. I mean, this uses pistons as well. You're not going to get a non-piston design. But definitely not doing the skeletons one. I don't think the pistons one is a great idea. So, it's Uma's design. And I mean, as you saw just a minute ago, it's no slouch. In Tango's video, because of course the iron golems down here are Tango's idea, he had golems on the other side as well. Well, that is actually doable. I could do that without lowering this any further. I was going to say I'd have to lower this a block to get golems in on that side, but I wouldn't. Can I get a slab in on there with the golems down there? I cannot, so I'd have to piston the slabs in. That's fine. So yeah. And I mean, this works fairly well. So in the middle here, we have my tentative design for the AFK room. So we've got glass elevator here, which I can just test because I've just got a dropper system and a chest here, just by way of testing. That comes up here, goes into the water streams, yada yada yada, nothing too special or new up here. AFK spot is here. That's pretty much it. And then you can see where the circle would go out to for the perimeter. It would actually go right across the edges of those. We've got redstone lamps with sea redstone lamps with redstone blocks underneath. They would have to be off over when it goes near a hut, obviously, so that it doesn't balk the spawns. But yeah, I threw this together. It took me a little while, but I think it's simple but effective as a design. So this is what I would go with. I mean, obviously, if anyone else wanted to take on designing this thing, they'd be welcome to, but this is my idea. It's dark oak and vines everywhere, and the item frames have gone. Oh, yeah, because I did a kill all entities. Whoops. And then we've got the crafting tables and the sneaky ender chest in the bottom there. So nothing complicated. I think it's this one. I think this one's a block higher than the others. And we also appear to have other mobs in there. They're not supposed to be able to spawn in there. Carpet. Slabs. No, I've got slabs in there. Carpet should prevent spawning. Slabs should prevent spawning. The algorithm shouldn't be able to start. How are mobs getting in there? That's weird. I mean, anything other than a witch will just despawn eventually. It's not too big a problem. But yeah, I think this hut was like a block higher than the others or something. Well, one of them was. And I'll have to check that on the world itself. But, random bones and arrows. Yeah. Oh, you can see this thing is clearly working. Not bad at all. So yeah, that's sort of the plan. The redstone lamps and redstone was Gooberoo's idea. No, I think that's a cool idea. We will just have the whole thing full of water. Eventually the plan is, or the idea we're batting around is to have like a bowl dug into the ground that will go down to bedrock. So it'd essentially hollow out the entire ground within the perimeter in the shape of the 128 sphere around the AFK point. Which is going to be about, 3 million blocks? I worked it out as very approximately. About 3 million blocks to excavate. You know, not too much. But yeah, that's kind of the plan. So look out for that in upcoming episodes. He says as if episodes are likely to come particularly soon. I'm just wandering over here for no particular reason. And I'm not sure why. I should probably head back or I'll get lost. Okay, I believe I've got everything I need. I think this is a good spot to build it. I can have a path leading up from there. And it'll, you know, be very visible. And I think I'll just flatten this area down a little bit. Because it's going to be an 8x8 base structure. And it's totally played out to do a firework for the shop. Because Mumbo did that, and Tango's done that, and probably everyone else under the sun's done that. But, you know, it's straight to the point. So how much space have I got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that should be enough. Okay. Something king there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Doesn't actually need to go there, but whatever, I'm marking it out. So if the path comes up there, the entrance is going to be there. And there's just going to be a pretty straightforward good thing I brought extra. I think I should make that a block higher given what I plan to do with it. Oh, I don't know, maybe not, because this is going to have a ring of stairs on top of it anyway. Can I have the rest of my stairs? No? No? 24 is probably not enough. 6, 7, 28, so I'd need another 4. That'll be easy enough, I'll just grab some stone. I'm going to grab these two blocks anyway. That gives me 5, so I just need one more. That's easy. Oh, hello. Could do with a spot of light over here. Okay, so let's just dig down and get some stone. That'll do. Let's clear out spaces. And yeah, stone brick's pretty bland, but that's just the base. So the next step is... Oh, hello. That's where you were hiding, is it? The next step is... Get some light in here, I guess. Okay, so I need my red wall and my white wall, and I'm going to build a firework. The nerve of it. Gooberoo came over here, saw my shop, seemed put out because he wanted to be able to have a shop, and then he's obviously decided to set up his own. Come on, Goob. Compete with someone who needs competing with, like, tech. Anyway, this is mine, which I built first, and it's obviously better. Obviously. It's all carpeted on the top, so it is spawn and snowproof. And it is time for the finishing touch. I'm not 100% sure that gives quite the effect I wanted, but meh. And now for something not to try at home, unless your server also has fire tick disabled. That won't burn the wall, and it won't go out either. But don't try it at home unless you have fire tick disabled. So, got a courtesy elytra launcher, which won't work yet. Still on 111. So obviously I'm just going to have fireworks in here. It's going to be fairly straightforward inside. And then the stuff-only area is down here. This will be sort of the workshop. It's very straightforward. Got the door mechanism here. Nothing too fancy. And then I'm going to dig out this way, because I'm going to put a sugarcane farm down here. At least that's the plan. Because I'm going to need paper for this. So I'm going to dig out a space. I need 18 wide by... how deep? 17, 18, about 20 deep-ish. So I'm going to get on with that and see you in a minute. Stage one is complete. Great big room. I actually just barely missed the redstone shop below. I didn't, like, check or anything, which is kind of stupid of me. But I just barely miss it. As you can see, share a couple of blocks in the wall. Anyway, I'm not going to build the thing on camera. I'll probably build one because I've made the room big enough for two of the things side by side. I'll probably just do one for now and do a second one another time. But I'm not going to do it on camera. So I will see you when I have built one side of this thing. And there we go. Fairly straightforward design. It's just got slime blocks, a bit of redstone, nothing too complicated. Laid out some of the ice over here, I didn't bring enough ice. So I'll just show you the redstone, it's pretty straightforward. So it comes around from the front, hits that piston first, so that pushes those slime blocks, same on the other side. Then 4 ticks after that, this one fires. Then 4 ticks after that, this one fires. Then 4 ticks after that, this one fires. So they're all synchronized. It does those two, then those two, then those two, then those two. So they're not all firing at once. And it's just pretty straightforward. Got water streams and ice. Water drops down here. And then hoppers will go at the bottom. All pretty straightforward. Didn't take too long to build. And I'll do the other one off camera. But that is going to be it for this episode. If you've enjoyed the return of Minecraft to my channel, please leave a like, share a favourite and comment, help support the channel, follow me on Twitter to stay up to date with what's going on, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. for an episode that will almost certainly involve the witch farm. No promises, but almost certainly. See you.